You're watching TV 69, Access Cable, Scratchurhaus, Massachusetts.
Well, I'm done with the paperwork. Would you like it now, or?
No, no, you can hang on to it. We'll be done with, when we're done with the interview, you can hand it in. Okay. What's your full name?
Michael Lou Ray McClure.
Is that a real name or a stage name?
It's a real name. Hey, what is this? I thought it was a lie detector.
Don't worry about it. It's a mild electrostimulus.
Mild?
It tends to make the person focus on the questions. We give it to all the employees. It didn't hurt any of them. How about you? No, don't worry about it.
Rattle.
Real name?
Fillins. Stage name. What is that, a temple bell?
Hey, open up.
Open up?
Open your mouth.
It's the last time you cleaned your fingernails.
Last week. Come on, pick. Get. Just go.
Hey, what is that? That's not bad.
It's the finest Dutch chocolate money can buy, for crying out loud. Trying to be nice here. May we proceed?
I'm sorry.
All right. What's your occupation?
You don't recognize my voice. I've done a lot of voiceovers. Oh, that's the way it's going to be. Okay, I've done some voiceovers. Is that bell? What, do you get a Buddhist temple next door?
Open. There you go. Oh. Any other skills we should know about?
Yeah, I've acted in a lot of movies. Well, mostly background. It's that bell again. That bell's really beautiful.
And what are you doing presently?
Well, I'm up for a role in a couple of movies. Oh, this is irritating. I might have some voiceover work. I'm collecting unemployment.
Open up. All right. I don't know why I'm doing this, but how'd you like to be an announcer on a new TV show on cable 69?
Well, what's the pay?
For you? It's a volunteer. There's no money involved.
I'd love to. Oh. What's the name of the show? Wait. Whisper in my ear. From. Live from East, what, Scratchurhaus?
Scratchurhaus.
Scratchurhaus.
Scratchurhaus. It's Indian.
It's Indian. Okay.
American Indian.
Oh, okay.
Live from East Scratchurhaus. It's the Frank and Earnest Show.
It's the Frank and Earnest Show. Brought to you by Nighttime by Lecterol. And the Horizon Network, ahead of the next. Our first guest tonight, former Massachusetts State Senator Francis Costello. Featuring musical guest Chicago Vinnie Earnshaw. Comedian Mike, the deaf comic Murray. With musical stylings by Slim Pickens and the East Scratchurhaus Average White All-Star Band. And finally, from the Rumpus Room, high atop Grain Silo number one, together again for the first time anywhere, the never-before-available players. And now, if you're not Frank, well, you must be Earnest. It's Frank and Earnest! Frank and Earnest Show is filmed in front of a live studio audience watching another show.
Hi, I'm Frank Wachowski.
And I'm Earnest Ianoa.
And we're Frank and Earnest!
And that's Michael Lou Ray McClure. Hey, for all you non-locals out there, I own a local bookstore / smoke shop.
And I own a hair salon.
We discuss current events constantly.
We seem to think that common sense seems to be fading more and more.
Oh, yeah.
When I'm sitting talking to my clients at my hair salon, we all seem to agree that no one seems to see the common sense solutions anymore.
No, they don't. I mean, like I said, if you want to die a rich man, you don't get divorced.
Yeah, is it better to forget her or cheaper to keep her?
Exactly. You think we should talk about the town?
Well, yeah, I think we should. It's our first show, and I don't think people in Massachusetts know about Scratchurhaus, and I think we should show the similarities between Scratchurhaus and other New England towns and peoples.
Yeah, I mean, it can't be that much different.
Exactly.
For instance, we were settled in 1687, but we weren't actually incorporated until 1807.
We were founded by Reginald Windischmere.
Yeah.
Who, by the way, was exiled from the Boston colony.
Yeah, he actually spent some time here with his family right after that happened.
Well, as the legend goes, Windischmere and the local Indian were looking in the area.
That's right.
When the Indian got bitten by a mosquito, at that same moment, Windischmere asked the Indian, what's this area called? And the Indian... not understanding English very well, said Scratchurhaus.
And it actually stayed that way from that little joke. That's actually now four sections of Scratchurhaus.
Well, actually five. There's downtown.
Yeah, oh, yeah. That's a real hole.
It's not a very nice area.
Yeah, well, just north is North Scratchurhaus.
Oh.
Now, that's nice.
Oh, God, is it ever. The lakefront property is absolutely gorgeous to die for.
Oh,
it's beautiful.
Yeah. Lower Back Lake is a beautiful place. It doesn't matter the season. It doesn't matter what's going on. It's a beautiful place to spend time with your family. But I'll tell you, you know, if you really want to take advantage of the shopping around here, you want to take a trip down to South Scratchurhaus. Big savings.
Where the family jewels.
Well, I like the...
Did you say family jewels?
You didn't let me finish. I was going to say family jewelers.
Yeah. There are three main jewelers down here. Silverman's, Tchaikovsky's, and the South Scratchurhaus Jewelry Exchange.
Now me, I like the West Scratchurhaus District. That's where I live. Hills, nice, quiet, scenic, beautiful.
But it's the same in the east side where I'm from, except for the dump.
I hope that covers the Scratchurhaus story.
I think it does. You know, I think it's time for our first guest.
I tell you, I've been waiting with bated breath.
I thought I smelled fish.
Oh, God. Welcome to that one.
Our first guest is going to be...
Hold on there, Frank. That's my job. And now our first guest is former Massachusetts State Senator Francis Costello.
Frank and Earnest is brought to you tonight by Nighttime by Lectoral.
Having trouble sleeping due to cough, cold, headache, fever perhaps? Look no further. Nighttime will solve each and every one of your problems. Just one shot. And you'll be sleeping like a little lamb.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our first guest, former Massachusetts State Senator Francis Costello.
Welcome, Senator.
Welcome, Senator. Thank you for being our first guest.
Thank you for having me. I consider this to be part of my routine for my regular constituents.
Oh, well, that's excellent. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself? Incidentally, you're not related to the mobster Frank Costello, right?
No. Oh. He's Italian.
So are you.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Costello is an Italian name. I mean, I ought to know. I'm Italiano.
I'm black Irish.
And I'm black Russian.
Number one, there's a group of Irish folks that ancestors, they're part Spanish. And number two, I do not pronounce my name Costello. It's Costella.
Oh, I'm sorry, Senator. I didn't know that.
No, I'm sorry. I know a lot about the Black Irish. I think it was just the name that screwed us up.
Well, today's topic, Senator, is going to be pension reform.
Yes, we do need pension reform.
But could you elaborate a little bit on what the Senate has to say about that?
Yeah, the pensions... are all messed up.
In what way?
Look, we can't even balance the federal budget, let alone the state budget. So we do need to work on the state pensions.
Are you saying that the pensions are becoming a burden to the state?
Yes, that's exactly what I was trying to say, that they are becoming a burden to the state.
But don't the people pay into them from their own pocket, like a 401k?
Yes.
And doesn't the state, isn't the state supposed to take that capital and invest it at a higher rate to pay off that offset?
Well, in theory.
What do you mean, in theory?
Well, we need a little bit of that money to balance the budget.
So you've been sneaking from the cookie jar a little?
Well, some.
Senator, some.
Well, a little bit more than some.
I should say so.
What about your pension?
What about my pension?
Well, I mean, your pension would be affected as well, wouldn't it?
Why would it be?
Because you work for the state.
No. No. I'm an elected official.
But don't you get a state check?
Well, yeah, I get a state check. In theory, I guess.
So, but this doesn't affect you in any way?
No, it doesn't affect me at all. Why should it? I didn't take a pay raise this year.
Well, that's nice.
No, Sinatra would say, that's not nice.
You guys are nuts. I should have known better than to come here today and try to have an intellectual conversation with a barber and a bookworm. By the way, love the hair, Frank.
Hey, I happen to like it, Lauren.
Oh, enough of this. Senator, don't you realize that the Occupy Wall Street movement is just a peaceful 21st century storming of the Bastille?
No. They're not patriotic at all. In fact, they're on drugs.
No, they're not. And so what if they were? You remember the 60s, the hippies? Look at the change that brought about.
We should learn from our history, Senator.
Hindsight is better than foresight, Senator.
Do you realize, Senator, if you get these people angry, the next thing you know, they're going to be acquiring weapons. And the first thing they're going to be doing is starting to look for someone like you. And the next thing you know is, bang, you're dead! Senator? Senator?
It could be just his time. Senator?
Senator?
Senator, could you... Maybe loosen up your tie.
You damn near killed me, you head.
I'm sorry, Senator. I just got carried away. I'm very sorry.
Oh, God. What is that smell?
I don't know.
Oh, no. You made me fill my depends, you dumbass.
Oh.
Sorry, Senator.
We're gonna go to a commercial break. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Get that money in here, just don't stop.
We'll try to cut this part out.
Incontinence. The inability of the body to control the functions of urination and defecation.
That's not funny.
Someone will be there shortly to help you. Okay?
Second door.
Second door on the right in the hallway.
you Sherman Peabody?
Yeah, who the hell are you?
This is your stress test.
Hey, that's not bad, man.
Hey, thanks. You got a 20?
Yeah.
You know, if I had your money, I'd throw mine away.
No, you wouldn't.
Oh, yeah?
Tonight on Lyric Theater, we interpret a sad blues masterpiece for you, Invitation to the Blues by Tom Waits. Oscar?
Well, she's up against the register with an apron and a spatula. Yesterday's delivery, tickets for the bachelor. She's a moving violation from her conch down to her shoes. Well, that's just an invitation to the blues.
We know right away the setting for our sad tale, a greasy spoon. Also of interest is the use of the 30s and 40s vernacular, such as conch, for someone's head. Invitation to Blues gives us a roadmap. If you will, an invitation of sorts to accompany our storyteller on his journey.
And you feel just like Cagney. She looks a lot like Rita Hayworth at the counter of Schwab's drugstore. You wonder if she might be single. She's alone and likes to mingle. Gotta be patient and try to pick up a clue.
It begins at the age-old two-step. He's considering chasing her, but doesn't have much to offer. She, on the other hand, is probably not a prize. So they circle each other like a pair of punch-drunk pugilists.
She says, how are you gonna like him, medium or scrambled? You say, always the only way. Be careful not to gamble on a guy with a suitcase and a ticket getting out of here. In a tired bus station with an old pair of shoes, this ain't nothing but an invitation to the blues.
May we glean from this that this is a man is proclaiming to a woman.
What the hell is this jackass talking about?
Interested in that he is a profound loser. Or is he trying to invoke her mother?
And who watches this crap?
In a bit of reverse psychology. Is someone of the lower class really that clever? I think not. But I will leave that to you to decide.
But you can't take your eyes off her. Get another cup of Java. Just the way she pours it for you. Joking with the customers. Mercy, mercy, Miss Percy. There ain't nothing left in Jersey but broken down jalopy of a man I left behind and the dreams I was chasing. A battle with the booze and an open invitation to the blues.
The man is obviously filled with doubt and self-loathing, yet he persists in his fantasy of
I'm
being
gonna kill
such
my
a
slinger.
He's down on his luck, yet he continues to denigrate himself. Battle with the booze, indeed.
She used to have a sugar daddy, a candy apple caddy, and a bank account and everything. Accustomed to the finer things, he probably left her for a socialite. And he didn't accept that night. He's a drunk, and he never told her that he cared.
Now he's taken to belittling her. It's all becoming a bit sordid. You might feel like a voyeur, peeking at two human wrecks.
And so they took the registration and her car keys and her shoes and left her with an invitation to the blues.
Here, I believe he's building sympathy for the woman. A terrible thing to base a relationship on. But what else would you expect from the lower classes?
Because there's a Continental Trailways leaving local bus tonight. Good evening. You can have my seat. I'm sticking around here for a while. Get me a room in the Squire. The filling station's hiring, and I can eat everywhere tonight. What the hell? I got to lose? I'll accept your invitation to the blues.
To sum up, a loser, probably an alcoholic, coming from nowhere.
What a loser.
Headed nowhere, sits down in a greasy spoon in a bus station and decides right away to abandon any plans that he may have had, trying to get a job pumping gas while he happens to be living, take a look at my notes, what is undoubtedly a flea bag motel, all so he can chase a woman who is in likelihood a bigger loser than
he. When the lights go out, you're going to get your own personal invitation to the blues.
Of the lower classes. Thank you for viewing, and good evening to all.
Please welcome Chicago Vinnie Earnshaw and friends.
Living in this rich man's world gets harder every day. If you don't got no money, you don't get to stay. Living in this rich man's world gets I'm up and generations fall. Down, down, vanishing, down, down, vanishing. Keep that wrecking ball. Scenes were meant to rise up. Generations fall.
And now, a word from our sponsor, Horizon.
Hi, I'm Kathy Williams.
And I'm Jeffrey Latham.
And we're here to tell you about the new phone from Horizon.
Horizon, ahead of the next.
It's the new Raspberry.
It uses the latest technology. It's faster and it's better than 4G.
It uses SIT technology.
SIT, suppository intestinal technology.
Not only is it faster, but you don't have to see or hear. You never take your hands off the wheel.
That's right. With SIT, everything is transmitted through the nervous system to the brain, including iTunes, YouTube, and videos. The deaf can now hear, and the blind can watch movies.
Oh, Jerry, all that. I bet it costs a bundle, and I bet it's bigger than an iPad.
Nope. In fact, it's so small, you put it in like a suppository, and you pull it out like a tampon. Or you simply just leave it there, and you watch videos in your sleep.
You can watch videos in your sleep.
It's not just a phone. It's your new best friend.
Hey guys, look what I came up with.
Gonna get dressed up, gonna get messed up, gotta hit the town tonight. He's gotta be tall and he's gotta be dark, and his pants just gotta fit right. So many minutes like Niagara, got me a pocket full of Guyagra. Viva Guyagra, viva Guyagra, viva, viva.
Clinical studies have shown that many men have an irresistible urge to paint their entire homes in lavender. In many clinical trials, men have exhibited uncontrollable weeping after hearing show tunes.
Unlike Viagra, Guyagra is suitable for gay, bi, and straight.
Side effects may also include a very comfortable feeling wearing just a cowboy hat and no shirt.
So many minutes like night.
Side effects may also include a sudden interest in your wife's friend's husband, Lauren.
Viva, viva. Looking for some fun.
Side effects may include a very different relationship with your friend Lauren.
Then I want to shoot off a rant. But I'm a lucky man, you see, because I got the right.
For the cowboy with an open mind, as wide as the open range.
Viva, viva, Guyagra.
I wonder, what does the future hold for Richard Dreyfuss?
In the future for Richard Dreyfuss, Well, I have an interest in playing Batman. As a matter of fact, I did audition for the role just a couple of weeks ago. It was a stellar performance. I was able to snag a copy of the audition tape right before I left. Check it out for yourself. I mean, I don't think there's any question why Richard Dreyfuss shouldn't be Batman. You know, the director said something about, you have a beard, we need to shave it off. You know, I don't need that working class hero crap. You know, Batman could have a beard. He could.
Four profiles in courage. I'm Jet Gardigan. Good night.
Have you ever dance with the devil in a pale moonlight? Have you ever danced with the devil in the pale moonlight? You killed my parents. Have you ever danced with the devil in the pale moonlight? If they hit the whole city with toxins, there's nothing to keep Gotham from tearing itself apart. Don't worry, Commissioner Gordon. I'm on top of it. Have you ever danced with the devil?
So funny. Alright, go again. All right.
If they hit the whole city with toxins, there's nothing to keep Gotham from tearing itself apart.
I never got a chance to thank you.
And you'll never have to.
Incompetent. Lacking the qualities for effective action.
I never got a chance to thank you.
And you'll never have to.
Wait. Hold on. It's not funny.
Please welcome Mike, the deaf comic Murray.
Thank you. Oh, I'm so happy to be here tonight. My name is Mike Murray, and let me tell you a little bit about myself before I get started. I was deaf until I was 40 years old. And then I had the cochlear implants put in both ears, and now I can hear. How cool is that? But that day, when they flicked that switch and sent me from the non-hearing world to the hearing world, that day I learned one thing. One thing that rocked my world. Farts make noise. They do. I mean, I didn't even know I was deaf growing up, man. I just thought it was real quiet. And it sucked growing up, especially at the breakfast table with my head in the bowl of Rice Krispies going, I got nothing. My parents used to feed me alphabets. Alphabets! Now, to some kids, it's a sugary treat. But to me, it was communication. My parents didn't even call them alphabets. They used to call them closed caption crunch. Tell you, my self-esteem was so low growing up because of my hearing loss. It was so low. My parents, to boost my self-esteem, signed me up for the disability games. I was like, you bastards. But then I thought, champion. Next thing you know, I'm in the starting blocks of a race. I look to my right, and it's a blind guy. And he's facing the other way. I look to my left, and it's a guy with one leg shorter than the other, you know? And he had one of those sneakers on with the extra rubber, which I felt was an unfair advantage, but still thought, gold medal. Next thing you know, they're crossing the finish line first and second. I'm still in the starting blocks because I didn't hear the damn starter pistol. True story. It was tough growing up. I grew up with, you know, six brothers and sisters, you know. And used to play games, but I played games a little differently. I played games like, what the hell did Simon say? If it was a pool party, I was the only one playing Marco. And pin the tail on the donkey? Come on, man. You want to blindfold me too? That's not pin the tail on the donkey. That's Helen Keller with the pin. But I tell you what, I will kick your butt in charades. I would kick your butt in charades. That game was over before we even started. As soon as you went three words, I was like, Kentucky Fried Chicken. One time my friends tried to fix me up with another deaf girl, you know. You know, I went out with her. But then I broke up with her. Because the whole sign language thing got old real fast. I even bought her a pair of mittens to try shut her the hell up. You know what? I had my first child before I could hear. I don't care what anybody says. I'm telling you, that kid slept through the night. I have 11-year-old twin girls. 11-year-old twin girls, these guys are nuts. They're crazy, you know? And one day last week, my wife was leaving for the day. She was leaving the day for the day and leaving me alone with the twins. And soon she leaves, soon she turns it back and goes out the door, I take my ears off. Because I can. So I take my ears off and I plop down on the couch and I start watching TV with the closed caption. And they're behind me. They're going crazy. They're going nuts. But I know they're fine. I know they're safe. But an hour and a half goes by. And my wife reappears in the doorway. She reappears in the doorway and she's going, what the hell is going on? But that's not how I saw it. I saw it like this. So I throw my ears on real quick. I throw my ears on quick and I said, what's going on? She's going, what's going on? I'm like, what? She said, I can hear these kids screaming from down the street. So we both look at the twins and go, what the hell is going on? And they said, I'm not making this up. They said, we just wanted to see how deaf daddy was. We just wanted to see how deaf daddy was. And my wife goes, but I can hear you as well as the whole neighborhood screaming from down the street. And they said, don't be mad at us, mommy, because now we know if anything happens to us when we're alone with dad, we're screwed. True story. I was telling my wife the other day, I said, you know what? It's too bad I'm not blind, too. I'd have twice as many jokes. She says all cocky. Too bad you're not mute. I wouldn't have to listen to them. My name is Mike Murray. Thank you very much. Have a good night.
You're watching TV 69, Access Cable, Scratchurhaus, Massachusetts.
Gig you got me?
Yeah.
I'm rehearsing for that gig. That gig's tonight.
All right. You know the job I got you here and the gig?
Yeah.
You can watch the dog between gigs.
I haven't got time to watch.
You have 5 minutes. What's 5 minutes? Well, I know you could even watch the dog
already.
I haven't
got the time. I'll show you. I'm rehearsing here. Hey, you know, I want to do the best job I can. I want to be great for you. You got me the gig, Jimmy.
I know I got
this
you
the gig.
I know I did. One hand washes the other. I need the dog wash, and you got to...
I'm going to do
Leo,
my best.
What is this?
That's my audience.
You wallpapered the wall with
dogs.
No,
I put up a couple of shots of dogs so I could talk to somebody. I need, you know, for a reaction, like pretend like I got an audience or something.
If you need an audience, I'll be the audience. Show me something. Right. Show me what you got.
All right, I'll show you. If you we get time, I'll do the dog. Only if we get time.
All right?
If we get the time.
What is this?
This is my stuff.
I'm the only one here. Who else is going
to
listen to you?
It's the way It's a setup, all right?
You need... Never mind that.
All right. Okay. You ready?
I'm ready. Go ahead.
Hey, it's great to be here in Boston. Thank you very much. Thanks, everybody. I love working in Boston. I'd love to live in Boston, but I can't live in Boston because it's the most expensive city in the world to live in. So expensive here, they sell it by the square inch. So I see this guy down on, you know, Newbury Street. He's passed out. He's got his pants down to his ankles. He's got a tattoo on his ass, and it says, "If you were me, you'd be home now." So I said to him, I give him a little nudge, you know, I give him a little kick. I said, "Hey, you know, what's up with you? Why don't you work?" He says, "Yeah, I worked all my life." I said, "You're about 17 years old. I got underwear older than you." Think I'm ready?
You're ready, all right.
Yeah.
You're ready to watch the dog.
Living in this rich man's world gets odder every day. If you don't got no money, you don't get to stay.
Hey, that's not bad. Is that one of yours?
Yeah.
Yeah?
You got 20 bucks?
15 bucks? What do you need 10 bucks for? I ain't got 5 bucks.
Living in this rich man's world gets harder every day.
What's not funny? What's not funny? Farcical.
And now, once again, Chicago Vinnie and Shaw and Friends.
1, 2, 3, 4. Clock is dripping off the wall. There's no time left at all. There are shadows in the night. Who's to say what's wrong or right? Downtown, where the marquee lights are bright. Downtown, gonna live my life tonight. I had to walk away. Going round, lots of hard talk in this town. Downtown, where the marquee lights are bright. Downtown, gonna live her life tonight. I had to walk away. I had to walk away. I had to walk away from you. Yeah, we've both been around. Know every alley in this town. I know how to get. Yeah.
Welcome, everyone, to another interesting evening of conversation. Tonight's guest is Professor Francis Deacon, who holds the title of Professor of Gender Identification at the University of East Scratchurhaus. Professor, welcome to the show.
Nice to be here.
Now, Professor, what exactly is gender identification?
Well, it's actually a bit of a misnomer. What I do is predict what an individual's decision might be based on his sexual proclivities. We thought that professor of sexual proclivities might be misunderstood.
That's fascinating, Doctor. I was wondering, is this some type of a psychic ability, or is it something that can be taught? I mean, how is it done?
Well, I can't actually get into details about the method we use because we've made an agreement with the government, which I do a lot of work for.
Well, Professor, could you give us a general overview?
Sure, I'd be happy to. We developed a program to identify a person's sexual tastes based on simple observations. We can pretty much predict in any given situation what a person might do.
Now, what type of application might the government have for this?
Well, again, as I stated earlier, I can't get into much detail. But can you imagine what the state government would do if they knew what the other side was up to? For example, the FBI in any given hostage situation, a bank robber, even so, a CEO in a large corporation. The possibilities, well, they're endless.
That's fascinating. I was wondering, Doctor, if, with your permission, we'd like to do a little demonstration here. We've set up a test, and we were wondering...
A test?
A test. You know, we're wondering if we could set up this demonstration where we show you video and you give us your impression.
Well, I don't know.
Well, if it's liability you're concerned with, Doctor, these people have all signed waivers. It's gone through the law department. There is no liability here.
Very well, but I reserve the right and the option to stop this if it goes where I'm not allowed to go legally.
That's fine, Professor. Could we bring up the first video, please?
I would say Butch Gay. Probably with tendencies to overcompensate. Especially if he's in a stressful situation, and to be more like his teammates, which could be potentially dangerous.
Doctor, you got all that from watching that video?
Of course.
Well, okay, I see. Could we roll the next video, please?
Straight, probably has 5 children. Very reliable and definitely stable.
Doctor, it is so hard to believe that you got all of that from watching that video. Okay, could we have the next one, please?
Well, that's easy. He's a ringer. And I might say, not a very good actor either.
Well, you got us, Professor. He is a ringer. It says a lot for your program that you caught us right off the bat. You nailed all those other videos. We'd like you to take one last look at another photograph to give us your impression.
Bipolar. Definitely raised in a strict Catholic
okay,
family.
Okay, Professor.
A rock star
we're running out of time.
Mildly schizophrenic.
Professor, we've run out of time. We have to leave. Thank you, everyone.
You son of a bitch! Where'd you go? Why'd you shut the lights out? I wasn't finished yet. Hello? Hello? Can anybody hear me? Hello?
And now, once again, Chicago Vinnie and Shaw and Friends.
Thank you. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Never coming back. Never coming back. Yesterday. Never coming back. Yesterday, walked through that door. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Come and gone with a piece of my heart and the key to my soul. Yesterday, walked through that door. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. No, she won't be back. Never coming back. Yesterday, walk through that door. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone, yesterday's gone.
Hey, everybody.
Thank you.
Hey, we did our first show, man.
Great show.
Isn't it
great.
A good one? I think it was fantastic. I'd like to thank our special guests.
Oh, let's hear it for Chicago, Vinny Earnshaw, and friends.
And let's not forget Mike Murray, the deaf comic. Mm-hmm. We'll give him a round of applause. But if he takes his hearing aids off, he won't be able to hear us applauding.
And the former senator as well?
Oh, we can't forget former state senator, Frank Costello.
Costello.
How did I forget that? Hey, you know, he used to be a barber before he was on this show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, notice?
Yeah,
I'm a
looks
little
good.
Trimmer. Yeah,
it looks
he
good.
Gave me a trim. After all we put him through, he went and gave, what a sweetheart, what a good, a great sportsman,
gave
don't you think?
Gave me a shave a couple times and helped me trim out when I did have a beard.
Well, that's why we're going through these pension problems. It's going to be a real close shave. Hey, thanks, folks. I hope you join us for our next show, and I hope you really, really enjoyed this show. On behalf of Michael Lou Ray McClure, my buddy here, Mr. Ernie Iannoa, and myself, Frank Wachowski, thank you and have a good night.
Thank you very much.